Next topic is exception hierarchy, which means java.language.exception class, which is the base class for all the exception class that are performed in the Java programming. The next one, all the exceptions and then error types are the subclasses of the class throwable here, which means the class throwable, which indicates the all the exception base classes which are performed under this class throwable. It is a parent class which has the two child objects. The one is an exception and another one is an error here. The next one is exception class, means these are the exceptions which are thrown under unusual conditions occur when the user program should not catch it to handle the exceptions. For example, it is a null pointer exception. The next one is error. Errors are the exceptions. Errors are the conditions which throw abnormal conditions could not be handled easily to find out the error. So what is the example means? A stack overflow, it is an example for the error conditions. Next, two types of exceptions in Java. One is a checked exception and another one is a unchecked exception. Checked exception, in the sense it can be handled the exceptions explicitly by the code itself, which means either by using performing the exceptions by try catch block or otherwise by the throwing block. The next one is an unchecked exception. Here you need not be handle the exceptions explicitly. Here we perform the JVM. JVM means a Java Virtual Machine, which is used to perform the handle these types of exceptions. And the next one is, here we are extending the checked exception by using java.language.exception class. Here for unchecked exceptions, we are using java.language.runtimeexception class here. The next one, what is the hierarchy in Java for exception is, first one is a throwable class, which inherited from error and then exception. Exception we are inherited from IO exception and then runtime exception here. Throwable, in the sense it is a derived class which is derived from the, it is a class which is derived from the subclasses. That is, we call it as a throwable here. That means using a keyword throw, which is used to perform the throw the exceptions here. What is the syntax means? Throw new throwable of subclass. Here that is, throwable is a subclass which define the properties of the exception class here. Exception class, in the sense it is a derived class here. Next one, the important topic which is performed in the exception handling is exception handling mechanisms, which is used to rectify the all the exceptions that occur in the program. So it is a mechanism which is performed in the Java programming. Next one, what do you mean by an exception handling? In the sense, it is a process of catching and handling the exceptions during the runtime of the program, which is known as the exception handling here. That is, when the error handling code, it consists of two segments. One is to detect and to throw an error, and another one is to catch the exceptions and to take the appropriate actions. That is, basically here we are having the two block performed here. The one is a try block and another one is a catch block here. The try block, in the sense it is used to create the exception object is created. After that, it thrown to the catch block. Here we perform the exception is handled what we throw from the try block here. Then this is a general structure of error handling mechanism. Basically we are having two blocks. One is a try block and another one is a catch block here. What is the general form of this exception handling form? Is a try, which performing some statements here, and then a catch. This is a syntax exception type and what the exception object occurred here. Finally, we are having the final block. What is the operations performed in here? Means in the try block, some statements are executed. If there is any exception occur in the try block, means it can be thrown to the catch block. What the exception is performed here, that will be explained in the exception object here. That is exception type. If you are having some arithmetic operation, if you have any number which is divisible by 0, if you are having a, that will be divisible by 0, in the sense what error will come. Here there is no possibility of dividing the number, any number, with 0. So in this condition, here what exception will occur, in the sense arithmetic exception will occur. block. Finally, our final statement is executed. Basically, a try block which have immediately a catch block or otherwise a finally block here. Next one. What are the exception handling keywords which are performed in Java? This may basically five types. The first one is a try and second one is a catch. Third one is a finally. Fourth one is a throw and fifth one is a throw statement here. The first one is a try statement. What is a try statement in the sense? It is monitoring inside in the try block. What the statements again? Here these are the statements which was performed in the try block. The next one is a catch. Catch the exceptions thrown by the try block. That means what are the exceptions that are occurring in the try block? It should be catched by the catch statement here. That is the second one, and it also handles the specific type of the exception performed here. What are the types of exceptions handled by the catch that also performed here? And the next one is a finally, which means what are the calls must be executed even though the exception may or may not be occur. If your exception occur only means catch block will be executed. Otherwise, there is a no need of the catch block which are performed under the try. So finally, it should be present whether it is an exception occur or not. It should be present after the try statement or otherwise in the catch statement here. Next one is a throw, which is used to explicitly throw an exception, and then it is used followed by the instance. Used Budhamudi method, it cannot be thrown as multiple exception. That means if you are performing, this is a method, a function consider. Inside this method, we have throw an exception here. That is used Budhamudi method here. Next one is a throws. It is used to declare an exception and it is followed by a class. It is used within the method signature, can declare the multiple exception here, which means you are considered this is a method, along with this method the throws exception is followed. So this is the difference between throw and throws here. That is a throw IO exception. Multiple exceptions perform means here you can follow, that is SQL exception. And otherwise we say arithmetic exception. These are the various kinds of exceptions performed with the throws here. Then consider one of the example program here. That is a class. Class name I given as an exception demo here. Next one is a public static void main string args function. In this we have followed a three variable. One is a a, b and c. I assign the value a as a 10 and b as a 0 here. In try statements we are following that c equal to a by b, which means here you are already assigned the value. What is the value of a? Here is a 10 divided by, value of b is 0 here, 10 divided by 0. It is not possible. So here the exception will occur. What exception will occur in the sense? The division in this sense, it is a follow of arithmetic operations here. So where exception occur in the sense, it is an arithmetic exception. Because any number which is divided by 0, an exception will occur. So try block exception occurred as arithmetic exception. So this exception is thrown to the catch block. That is arithmetic exception of the object type is, that is exception type is E here. Next one, what exception will occur? Arithmetic exception in this sense, it is divided by 0. Any number which is divided by 0 means it will indicate the exception of divide by 0 here. So the next one is you have to print the value of what is the a and what is the b. So finally what output will come means it is a divide by 0, and then what is that value of a is 10, the value of b is 0 here. Any Java program which uses to compile means what you want to write is Java C. What is the here? Consider an example program here. What is the name you are giving? Exception demo. Java. This is for compilation. While you are running the program, you have to write a Java and then class name. Exception demo. For all the programs, this is the what is the compile for compiling the Java program, you have to write a Java C, class name.java. The next one for execution. next one is using finally keyword. This is one of the keyword of exception handling mechanism. Here by using finally keyword, we see an example. Here the class name was finally demo, and then initializing the variables of a equal to 10 and b equal to minus 1 here. In try function, we have one condition that b equal to a divided by 0. In initializing the value a as 10 here. So 10 which is divided by 0. It is not possible. So division is an arithmetic operation. So we have to write the exception as a arithmetic exception here. And then what exception occur in here is divide by 0. So in catch statement, the exception occur in the try statement is arithmetic exception. So here I write the arithmetic exception E as in a catch. The exception occur as arithmetic exception that is thrown to the catch statement here. In this catch statement, I print in the catch block. After that, finally one block. Finally is a keyword which is printed repeatedly after either after a try block or otherwise a catch block. After the try block or catch block, finally keyword should be written. So last finally have one condition, that is a b which is not equal to minus 1 means this, if the condition is true means this will if block will be executed, otherwise the else block will be executed. We are already having the value b which is equal to a minus 1 here. So if you are substituting b as a minus 1, the condition is equal, that is b value has minus 1, the condition value is minus 1. The condition is false here. So your else block will be executed. That is finally block executes with an occurrence of exception here. So what is the output means? First you come to the exception throwing the catch block, it will be executed firstly. The catch block, that is the first one. What exception occur here? Arithmetic exception. That is java.language.arithmetic exception. What is an exception? Divide by 0. Then we write. And finally, if the condition is false means the statement is executed. That is finally block execute with an occurrence of an exception here. The next one is using the keyword throws. See one example program. Here the class name is exception throws. So static void function. That is the void function is a method function here. We already discussed about that. Throws function is repeatedly having along with the method itself. So you are having two values, that is int a and b. Throws the arithmetic exception here. So int c, next try function, you are having the expression of c equal to a divided by b. Next one here, the what exception will throw here is divide by 0. Because we are assigning the value in the main function, a is 5. Your function is calling a comma 0. That is a value is 5 but b value here is 0. So what exception? Try it. That means c equal to a divided by b. In this condition, you are having the a value as 5 and b value as 0. So this condition will occur means what exception? Divide by 0 exception will come. So in catch statement, the exception is coded here. After that, in main function, your a value is 5. Function of performing that a as a 5 and a b as a 0 here. So what is the output in the sense? The exception thrown is divide by 0, that will be coded by the call exception. Then you are having plus arithmetic exception which is divided by 0 here. Next we can see an example program for throw here. Throw in the sense, this is a keyword which is used inside the method. And it can also perform the multiple exceptions here. That is a class exception, class name is throw here. In a function, that is a static void function, since it is a method function, in that we are having the two causing parameters, one is a A and another one is a B. Here you are declaring the variable as a C here, and you are having one condition, that is if your B value which is equal to 0 means your output will throw an exception. That is what output, if the condition is true means it will throw an exception here, otherwise it will else part is executed. Your main function, you are again assigning the value is a is a 5. A function of calling of a comma 0, then a value is a 5 and b value is 0 here. So you are substituting here, your b value is 0. So 0 which is equal to 0 in the sense, that is the condition is true. So you are throwing, it will throw an exception of arithmetic exception divided by 0. one is the nested try statements. Nested try statements and then inside the try statement, another try statement will be performed. That we call it as a nested try statements. That is, there are the chances of occurring the multiple exceptions, more than one exceptions that occur in the try statement, which we call it as the nested try statements of different types for the same set of the statements. While you are forming the same set of statements, there may be a different types of exceptions occur. That is defined here. And such a situation can be handled by the nested try statement. Consider one example here. There is a class name which is a nested try demo, and then public static void and string here, main function you are defined here. In this first, this is here outer try statement. That is a try which includes of int a, which is equal to integer dot parsing of Georgius of 0, which means the integer dot parsing of method. It is a method which is used to convert multiple catch statements to perform the exceptions here. Next, the syntax for multiple cap statement is there must be a one price, single price statement. Depending on the exception rule, there are the multiple cap statements which are followed under the try conditions here. So try statements, here what exceptions will occur? It can be thrown to the different types of the catch exceptions, what they occur. The first one is the syntax of catch, which is catch, the exception type, what we have declared, either it is an arithmetic exception or an array index of out of bound exception, or otherwise it may be a number format exception. Whatever the exception occurs, they will be given to the exception type, or what are the variables that will be assigned to the, for the exception type. Here in the catch block, what exception is thrown from the try block that will be handled in here. So there may be a multiple catch statement based on the exception occurs in the try statement here. Consider an example here that is a multi-class, class name which defined as a multiple catch demo here. In this main function, we have to assign the value of A in the array of that is int size is 3 here. So basically, your array